universities, and then you specialize. You go into medicine, you go into science, you go into whatever, and then you go through the same system on a higher level. So, and those are the people that then get appointed to run the system, to run medicine, to run science, to run this, to run the other. And by the time they get to those positions where they run society, they're completely encased and controlled by this low level of awareness called intellect. And therefore, society reflects their perception of the world, i.e., we live in a society based on intellect and mind. When you become conscious, the world changes and your world changes. You see, people encased in mind in Israel as we speak will justify the slaughter of Palestinian people.
They're in that tiny paradigm.
Stop Hamas. But there are some fantastic people in Israel, Israelis, young people particularly, who are conscious, and consciousness is telling them this is wrong. And they're the ones that are refusing to serve in the military and going to jail as a result. Because consciousness is getting them to see the situation from the point of view of what's right, what's just, what's fair. Rather than from mind, which sees things in
tiny they're also fundamentally getting out of just the their earth suit and realizing they're not Israelis, they're human beings, or they're
exactly.
not.
Exactly, that's what consciousness does. Consciousness, once you become conscious, the physical body becomes a vehicle to experience this reality. It doesn't become who you are, and then racism and division through race and division through country suddenly starts to fall, and we start to realize we're all one consciousness having different experiences.
Okay,
but
stop.
What's happened, Alex, and the conspiracy is fundamentally set up to do this, the idea is to get us to identify who we are with our experience rather than what we really are, which is consciousness having the experience.
Instead of being our base, galactic programming of this ancient species in this wondrous universe, they're trying to give us the new false programming to stay within that very limited spectrum as you talk so much about. And we're almost out of time, and I promised to go to calls, so we're going to go to break in a moment. We're going to come back and take calls for two short segments with David Icke. We've got to have you back soon, David. We're very thankful and appreciative of your important time, and I know the audience is, but briefly, in the 3 minutes before break, the genetic engineering, the cloning of the milk, all of this that is now going on and happening, the cross-species engineering, the mass poisoning of the public. Why is the elite pushing to destroy the biosphere of the Earth while grandstanding and claiming they've got to have world taxes to save it with carbon dioxide that's a red herring? Why do they want to destroy the Earth and hurt the environment?
Well, this actually goes on for what we've been talking about. If you take one step back and you start to see what we're dealing with here, from their point of view, particularly from their point of view, the human body is a computer system. And what we call genetics is actually a computer program. And what they're doing by messing with genetically modified food and all these other changes in the nature of what we eat and drink is they are manipulating, destabilizing and manipulating the body computer program. On one level, the body is an electrochemical organism. So if you destabilize it electromagnetically or chemically, you're destabilizing it. You're stopping it working efficiently. You're stopping it being a highly efficient receiver-transmitter for consciousness to experience through it and to influence its behavior. You're disconnecting it from consciousness and pulling it into
mind. Which is what the mercury and the poisons and the GMO, and when we get the government documents, and we get them out of England and out of Russia and the U.S., it says we got to poison them when they're young so they never fully develop, and they're literally like biological androids.
That's exactly the game, and this is why, again, the point you made earlier, I've been talking about this for years, this a massive assault on human freedom, on the human body, on the human mind, is because this period of change, this cycle is coming, and it's waking people up, and they're desperately trying to keep the lid down so that they can control for the next cycle, and therefore they're attacking the young particularly, because they're going to be the adult people as this cycle really unfolds, and therefore they need to destabilize them. And that's why their food and drink is attacked more than
anybody. And that's why we've got the kids being put on Ritalin, Prozac. David, for PrisonPlanet.tv viewers, I'm only doing it with one segment today because time's precious. We're going to talk behind scenes for the PrisonPlanet.tv and Internet listeners right now, and then come back to your calls after break. Stay with us.
Philip.
Okay, John, I'm going to skip this break. David, we are just on the internet audience now because I promised to come back to calls. Let's put bookends on what you just said. I just read the other day in the New York Times, 100 million people on serotonin reuptake inhibitors alone. If that isn't THX-1138 Brave New World, I don't know what is. They're attacking the police, the military, the citizens. All of us are in this together. And isn't that the great final illusion, is that people that work for the system feel like they're part of the elite when even high-level elites are being poisoned by their own system? And that's why people say it's a spiritual thing. There's almost this cosmic force, and you get into that. But I just can see that it's there driving man towards destroying themselves, and it's overall a hatred of the species.
Yeah, the thing is, I say to this to people in uniform, you know, I say to them, you know, you've got no power. You know, there's some people that love the uniform because they think they've got power. And I say to them, you've got no power. Your power is what you put on in the morning when you open the wardrobe. The uniform you wear is an extension of the state. When you wear the uniform, you're an extension of the state. When you take the uniform off, you have no power. And the only power you have is of the state. You're just another pawn in the game while thinking you are higher than the other pawns that you're policing. And these are the levels of society, these policers of society, which Obama wants to massively increase with his
pyramids.
Networks of civilian security. These are the people that need to wake up and need to realize that they have children too. I know of one who's high in NATO who's just realized, he said he looked in the eyes of his four-year-old grandchild and said, I can't do this anymore because I know what I'm contributing to now, and he's trying to get information out about what's going on. This is what we need to do. The policers need to realize that they are the pawns also.
Well, I was talking to a top doctor who's treated a head of state, and this head of state said, you know, I was grown up to, you know, that we have to exterminate 80% of people to keep the resources, but I look at people and I know it's evil and I don't want to be part of this. I mean, a lot of people in the system are having an awakening too, aren't they?
Yes, they are. So there's so much to be optimistic about. I mean, the challenges are there. Of course they are. They want to push this on. And they want to push it on faster and faster now because they are desperately trying to stop this awakening manifest to such an extent that their house of cards comes down. So those challenges are there, and they're going to push on through Obama. But there's so much to be enthusiastic and encouraged about, because there is fantastic changes going on in the awareness of so many people.
David, as you said, though, in the 1 minute before we come back, quickly, I'd say Obama has 2 or 3, 4 months when he first gets in till people wake up to that phase of the illusion. So they want to start a big war or a biological release or a financial collapse. What do we do to expose this guy and stop him being able to carry the ball for the New World Order in the first few months?
Well, what we've got to do is keep whacking this information out. And people who are listening to this information, don't be a cul-de-sac for information. When you receive the information, there is a responsibility. Pass it on, pass it on, pass it on. By word of mouth, you can inform vast numbers of people very quickly if enough people do it. That's what we need to do.
You're right, and we have incredible power, but we better use it now because they are planning to shut down the old web. The inventor of the web said a few days ago that quote, it's going to die. They're letting it die. It's being killed. So we need to move right now. Folks, we're coming out of this break with only PrisonPlanet.tv viewers and Infowars.com exclusive stream listeners. Tuning in, though we do have tens of thousands tuning in on the free streams and quite a few watching on PrisonPlanet.tv. We're coming out right now with David Icke with your calls. Here we go.
From his Central Texas Command Center, deep behind enemy lines, the information war continues. It's Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
The New World Order, with its programmers, admit that they're colonizing our minds, our souls. They are keeping us weak, confused, dumbed down, infighting. But the awakening is happening. David Icke, amazing guest, is our guest right now. DavidIcke.com is the website. We'll put that up on screen. Let's go to Ryan, first-time caller from Georgia. You're on the air with David Icke.
Yes, how you doing, Alex? First off, I just really want to tell you I'm very appreciative of this waking me up and informing me of all the information that's currently going on. And second, I just really wanted to say, by far, I've been wanting to say this for a long time, Lindsey Williams, David Icke, Steve Quayle, and Tex Mars are by far your most important guests that you have on your show. And I would just really appreciate if you can even get them on even more, because every time they speak, they get really straight into the point, and they inform us with information of how these people